going hot. Oh, it's going hot. Ooh.
You're looking at one tough woman tangoing at 108 years old.
You okay, Anna?
Yeah.
All right.
Meet Anna Del Priore, a survivor of two global pandemics. Anna's family says she caught the flu in 1918, the deadliest of all time. But she beat it at just 6 years old. And more than 100 years later, she got COVID-19 in May at her nursing home in Middletown, New Jersey. She battled it for 6 weeks.
What was it like to see her suffering from coronavirus?
We all felt so bad for her, but she bounced back.
Bounced back all right and conquered coronavirus.
I'm sure there are a lot of people, Miss Anna, who want to know what the secret is to living so long.
To be honest and kind, believe in God, all the good stuff.
60 miles away in Queens, New York, Anna's younger sister, Helen. She's 105. In March, she also got COVID-19 and had to isolate.
I miss you, Nick.
I know, Mom. I miss you, too.
Her son and granddaughter couldn't visit.
When we heard that she had the coronavirus, I thought that was it. I thought this was the end.
I didn't.
And she's so strong.
I said, there's no way this is bringing her down. Not after all these years.
Nicole was right. Grandma made a full recovery.
It is possible that these are America's toughest sisters.
Yeah.
Miss Helen, how often are you exercising?
I do it every night before I go to bed. I kick my legs. I go up and down, 10 times.
All your life, you watch what you ate.
I miss my Italian food.
Oh, you do?
Spaghetti and meatballs.
The sisters FaceTimed on their birthday last month.
Hey!
Yes, they were also born on the same day, 3 years apart. After the call, friends and family rolled by in a car parade outside Anna's nursing home. The birthday girl took it all in from her giant throne.
I felt so important.
The takeaway is to be joyous and to find like the happiness in life.
It's clear these sisters are intent on joy, smiling and dancing through life. For the news, I'm Contessa Brewer.
I absolutely love it. Contessa, thanks so much.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.